Race is not where the line is drawn. It's God's side and the other side.
I'm gonna try to get through this. Thank you.
Jewish synagogue members clashed with the New York Police Department to prevent the tunnel from being sealed off.
Love it.
You love it?
I love it.
Really?
I really do.
Oh, yeah. Come on.
Excuse me, I'm a Jew, and I just like to say that, you know, in our Bible it says that you're like animals.
Oh, yes, to warm out. Oh, yeah.
Love it. Oh, love it. Just like this.
The rabbi actually puts his mouth around the penis and sucks the
blood. Hey, good to see you again.
I am the only human alive. I am the only
human. All right, how's everybody? Good, good, good.
Hey, you don't do that in America.
This is a city. I mean, this is a city in danger.
People are entitled to their sexual proclivities.
I'm trying to eat somebody's ass because I'm a mutt.
Double whopper.
Double whopper, nigga.
All lies will be exposed. That's all.
Oh, my goodness me.
It's like, yeah, the whole time, it's like the fuck no.
These bunch of sex trafficking mongrels are about to be exposed.
I'm leaving.
Try this. Let me see your key.
How'd you like two towers?
I just have to pull the reins on you. I'll just make sure the horse doesn't go crazy.
Yeah, I mean, hey, dude, listen.
I'm halfway through. So, I mean, I got the... Shane told me I would like Lord of the Rings compared to Harry Potter. I do really love Harry Potter because of the magic. We were talking about that the other day where it's like people with powers is... it gets
How do you
me.
Think you would handle the ring?
Oh, my God, dude. You call me Boromir. That was like kind of mean.
You're Boromir, bro.
Come on, dude. I don't want the power.
He
I can
redeems
tell you
himself
that.
In the end.
But there's, I mean, I'm in the middle of the towers, and it seems like Samwise should have the fucking thing the whole time. Because
he's a retard. He'd never make it to Mordor by himself.
He would never make it to Mordor, yeah. But I'm just saying at least holding the ring. Like, he can hold it, because fucking right now, Frodo Baggins is having a rough one with that ring. Bro.
Oh, yeah, man.
They
it
just got through
you.
The bog.
It comes for you.
Yeah, that is, it is.
I think that there's a thing, I don't know. I think Tolkien might have wrote that off of Socrates. There's a Socrates thing.
It strikes a nerve deep in your DNA where, like, this is the coolest shit in the world.
It's real old. There's, like, an old argument that Socrates has, and they make up a story with, like, some dude rolls up on a giant, and the giant has a ring, and he just takes the ring. He's like, no big deal.
Yeah.
He's chilling with his boys. He puts the ring on and he gets invisible. And he's like, oh, shit. He takes the ring back off and he's like, I'm not going to tell anybody about this. And then he starts the fucking hand rubbing.
I mean, I don't know. Like, everyone wants
that up.
Everyone wants to say that they would handle the ring fine. But if Arwen or whatever.
Oh, man. Arwen?
Who's the queen that, the elf queen that spazzes about the ring? Like, I would be so loved.
That was a sick scene.
Dude, that is
I
like...
I think that's only in the... I don't know. That might be in the regular movie. I mean, I've watched so many of the extended editions.
I'm only extended edition. I bought the trilogy. I gave money to Tolkien, bro. I bought the trilogy.
The Tolkien estate.
Yeah.
Yeah, Lady Galadriel would be a queen.
It's insane.
A powerful queen, dude.
Yeah, but like that chick, like that right there is a perfect example of chicks. Where it's like, I'll be the queen. Everyone would fucking have to love me.
Yeah, I mean, that's that whole performance she puts on. Gandalf literally did the same thing going like, Frodo, like, I would take the ring, but I'd get fucked up from it.
Yeah.
He doesn't put on any kind of show.
He's at least fucking real. But.
I love when he breaks into Black Speech.
Yeah, Black Speech
I'm just stoked you're watching it because now you're going to get all the shit I say from Lord of the Rings. I'm constantly saying shit from Lord of the Rings and you just stare at me.
It's like when I quote rap songs.
Yeah,
it is. I kind of went to sleep juiced up because they got through the bog. They had the fight with the orcs. The orcs are like semi-scary, at least for like going to sleep. Like when I go to sleep, I just start like fucking seeing shit. So like I'm thinking of orcs in my head and shit and it's like kind of fucking freaking me out. And I'm having racing thoughts about how it's going to end. I did see it in theaters.
I had nightmares as well from my research.
Did you really? Yeah, well.
When they're all dancing at once, dude.
I don't know. This is.
They start sweating. They get packed into a room like you wouldn't. Like, this is.
The orcs.
They, dude.
The dwarves.
They start to sway when they get excited. Like, collectively, they know something's going to happen. They start to sway, and then the Rebbe comes in.
Whatever the no homo is for anti-Semitism, this one's running the whole cast.
What do you mean?
Like, you know, you say some gay shit where you're like, I'm not gay, no homo.
Dude, I'm not. I don't think. I watched these documents. You said, oh man, I'm going to look into tunnels. You just look into the ciabatta. I'll go, okay, cool.
Ciabatta bread. Is that where it's from?
No, it's challah bread.
I don't mean like
first
ciabatta.
Of all this is challah and chabad.
Say it right. Don't say it wrong.
Chabad Lubavitch.
The ciabatta.
From Russia. But yeah. Dude.
What year?
What do you mean?
Do you know, like, when they started in Russia?
It's a place in Russia.
Oh.
1800s. 1812. Okay. That's where we get the first, the Tanya is written by the first Rebbe.
Yeah, I mean, this is, what's it called?
Dude, when I watched the one documentary I sent you.
They're wild, dude.
Bro, there's two documentaries that if you think you hate Jews, dude, or some, if you think that you got a problem with these guys,
yeah,
watch them speak with Australian accents or British accents. I want to know why our ones. First of all, Yiddish fucks. Can I play that one clip?
Yeah, play whatever. I'm not even hooked up. Oh, yeah. I mean, you can play whatever clip you want.
You might, hey, dude, edit this out, see, I guess, if I hook up. But.
See if you, yeah, I'm not connected on Bluetooth, so see if you're connected on Bluetooth. I mean, do they, like, code switch American ones? It's like, there's,
mean?
Like,
it's Yiddish is their first language.
But I'm saying, like, do they, the Australian ones don't talk like that?
I'll try to pull up a clip, dude. Like, there's a fucking, I'm sorry.
You're good. Just hook up the Bluetooth.
There's too many windows open because there's so much.
This is overstimulating.
This is
dude.
Way overstimulating for me. Man.
I thought that, like,
you can't put me on the Chabad.
I thought they got, like,
so the best
AI or something that did this. When I saw a dude crawling out of the sewer, dude, I was like, what the fuck is going on?
The best one I saw in my deep research was the Hasidic drug dealer Samuel Leibowitz. He's British.
Yeah.
I mean, I'll try to pull up a clip if we pause it of him. He's fucking hilarious.
Pull the clip up.
This is my top yid.
We're going to end off with this question. Before we ask the last question, I want to once again thank Agudas Yisrael for facilitating and hosting and enabling this kind of session, this format, for those who are here and who are watching from
other
places.
This is Yiddish. It's fucking
nuts.
There
has been a tremendous increase in anti-Semitism lately, like nothing we've seen in recent years. In Congress, in our own backyards, Jackson, Toms River, Ramapo, and across the country.
Ramapo?
What should be the response of a Ben Tyrod be?
Let the man speak.
Just davening? Should we be engaging in a response across social media? Should we write letters to our elected officials? Should we look to move to Eretz Yisrael? Or should we lay low, keep quiet, and hope it passes? But isn't that what the Yidden did in pre-war Germany?
May oivai techakmeini.
Right now,
as we speak, ladaiti. A tremendous, tremendous, tremendous contributor to anti-Semitism are three Jewish politicians with Jewish names, Jewish faces, who are going after the sitting president of the United States.
You can understand this.
Yes.
What we feel and what we say about that president.
These guys are like jazz music. This is like the scat.
They are in the front of this battle against the president without any gavul. One is the head of one committee, one is the head of another committee, one is a sitting senator of our state of New York. It's a bazillion. It's a churbin. Someone told me the other day that there's a website coming out of Florida of a gentleman, that he said on his website.
You probably learned these words underground.
He says the guy has 3 million followers on his website. It's no volume. To me, that's only the these assimilated Yidden that don't even know what a Yid means. They don't even know what a Bechlal means to be a Yid. They're the message to us. Do we realize we're in Golus? Do we realize what Golus means? Do we realize that Golus means we're in a host country?
Bro,
and thank you for letting us in. And thank you for not kicking us out, because our real place is Eretz HaKodesh. Uvitnei chatoenu golinu me'atzenu. V'nisrachaknu me'al admosenu. Not 1,000 years ago. Today, last Sukkot, when we said mitnei chatoenu, this is what it means.
All right, dude, that's enough.
What the fuck, dude, is Sukkot?
I tried, dude, I got to... Dude, I got a book on.
Imagine hearing that under your concrete floor in your basement, dude.
Dude, I got a book on him. I got a book on him called The Rebbe, The Rebbe's Army. Just trying to fucking learn, man. Yeah. I'm not cultured.
Holy shit, dude.
Dude, it's fucking hilarious, man.
What the fuck is going on?
But to hear the one guy's dad, the one guy got he got touched in Australia in the mikveh.
That's
all right. So dude, he got touched in the mikveh. He got stroked off by a security guard, and you know it's the same as the Catholic Church. They all kept it under wraps.
Yeah, yeah.
The dudes, but then the community, they don't like it. They're real closed off, dude, and they don't like it when they go to the regular authorities.
Mm-hmm.
So now they're all coming at him saying, oh, it's the Danny, I think his name's Danny or something. They're like, oh, it's the Danny Wax show. Like, he's putting on a show. Like, he wants all this attention because he got touched.
Holy shit.
You know, and he's sitting there going, he's asking, like, the head Rebbe, he's like, dude, is this guy still touching people? And the guy's like, maybe. They don't give a fuck, dude.
Did you read the Vice article? It was, like, the child rape assembly line.
No, no.
So, like, this is the weird thing about the tunnels. So the tunnels allegedly are going to, like, mikvahs, which is, like, where they, like, wash off. So
hold on. You want to get educated on a mikvah real quick?
Yeah, go ahead.
So the real purpose for the mikvah is so that, hey, if you want to clean spoons, get them kosher. If they get into the meat or the milkies, they cannot combine.
Milk and meat can't combine?
Milk and meats can't combine, so they got to wash it off. It's a holy water
thing.
That
means 1002 is fucking that's pretty very anti-kosher.
It's pretty much like it's a pond where you can clean shit, but it's for girls. After they have
the periods, right?
After they have their nidda, they go into the mikvah. Just
say the normal word.
What, dude? I'm trying to learn.
They call their periods niddas?
Niddas.
Okay.
Yeah, once you have that, hold on, let me read my book. Do the nitta, dude.
This is the ultimate L for Jews.
I'm sorry. Yeah, the nitta is like a menstruation period.
Yeah, but like this was in mikvah allegedly, and then the child rape assembly line thing for Vice, they were saying like this rabbi was like, I rolled into a mikvah or mitvah, whatever the fuck it's called, and there was a rabbi butt fucking a little kid.
Oh yeah.
And saw the dude roll in and just didn't stop.
They don't give a fuck.
And then he was like, dude, what the fuck is your problem? Can't you see I'm doing something here? And everyone went in on him, and he was like saying it's like upwards of 50% of like Hasids get fucking touched coming up. It's like a rite of passage for those dudes.
Yeah, I think that's why that Danny Wax guy is getting all that
yeah
shame.
So as far as the Chabad Lubavitch, that's the crazy thing is, it's the world headquarters for Hasids in New York. That's like pretty fucking insane.
Well, no, they're a sect.
But they said this is like their one in Crown Heights is
yeah,
Gullis.
It's complicated. So like, dude, I don't want to freak you out. So I don't know what sect those dudes I played were. But the Chabad, yeah. They've talked to every president since Nixon.
Oh yeah,
they're trying to
see the pictures.
They're trying to portray these dudes like they're like some whacked out Amish.
Well, the thing is, they do that and they try to say that they have no affiliation with Israel and they're actually anti-Israel.
They make $1 billion a year. They're friends with every Israeli prime minister.
Obviously,
he was encouraging Netanyahu to speed things up to bring on the Moshiach. That's the Messiah. All right, yeah.
So like blowing up Kushner's Gaza to bring
guys,
the
oh yeah, dude, it's nuts. The main Chabad guy that's fucked up is oh, you know what pissed me off was the fucking Marvel shit.
Oh yeah, I mean that was crazy.
They're all Chabad'd up too.
Yeah, obviously, dude. It's Hollywood.
Yeah, but I mean, it's this one fucked me up. So that's there's RFK.
Oh yeah, dude.
You know. RFK Jr.
I know, that dude's brutal, who he's taking a picture with.
Yeah, but the guy in the picture in the back, that's the Rebbe.
Oh, okay.
That's the main Rebbe.
Yeah, I mean, the weird thing about these dudes is they stop at, like, third grade, and they're super poor.
Nah, they don't. They can go up to, like, 14.
Learning.
Yeah. Bob Dylan, big-time Chabadder.
No, he's not.
Yep, Bob
really?
Dylan. He had a...
What's his real name?
He had a flirtation... Zimmerman. he had a flirtation with Christianity in the 80s, but the Lubavitch guys came in and saved his ass.
Yeah, they get him out of there.
And his main rabbi is this dude named Manus Friedman, and he wants to destroy all the holy sites of the Arabs, kill all men, women, and children, just go take Israel, stop fucking around.
Whoa,
oh,
dude.
Yeah, dude. Openly, yeah.
These dudes are just saying this like no big deal.
They don't give a fuck, bro.
Yeah, I've seen, like, there's videos of Hasids that are just fucking crazy. Like, that one I seen in Germany, that dude just throwing up on a chick and then hitting the dude in the head with a bottle.
I mean, the one I sent you is nuts.
Which one?
The one from the City of Joel thing I watched.
Yeah. Well, that's, like...
Those guys do drug trafficking. Times of Israel reported on it. They'll get Colombian coke dealers to come in with, like, $4 million, and they wash it with what's called a jamach, where it's like they fucking have a free loan.
Yes, a bridge loan.
Yeah, it's like a bridge loan where they just take in it. It's like a gamak, something like that.
Come on, dude.
I'm trying. My mouth doesn't make these sounds, bro. You want me to read this stuff?
The City of Joel stuff's weird because, like, they spaz, like, everyone's out to get us, and, like, they fucking roll into, like, cities and just fucking multiply, like, over and over again, then take over, like, townships. Then it's,
yeah,
like,
they do, like, 8 to 14 kids.
That's fucking...
One dude in Australia had 17 brothers and sisters, or 16 brothers and sisters.
They're not so different from their Muslim brothers.
Oh, yeah, but those guys in Yoel are anti-Zionist, so they're not all the same. That's why I was saying that.
Yeah.
There's, like, Satmars, and the dude from England is the Satmar. He's the best. He did time. Dude, he did, like, all this time in jail, and now he's back to the community.
Yeah, that's fucking insane. Like, the weird shit about this is the amount of lies that is going on about how it actually went down. Like, from when it went down until now, I've read a different story literally every fucking hour. Like, what do I have here? Yeah, at first it was New York utilities were filling shit in. Everything was completely fine there, and they couldn't figure out why it was fucking happening. They're trying to refill some fucking hole. It was a huge fucking opening. Then they try to find it. Allegedly, that's the first story. They get to here and, like, oh, this is where the fucking thing is. And then I fucking read a story where it's these guys warring with themselves because misfit youths who dug a fucking tunnel.
Well, they're misfit students. I don't think they're youths.
What is a student?
They can be students, like, way into being. Dude, if you could see how old fucking Sammy Leibowitz looks like. Well, he's 38 years old. This motherfucker's like an American 60.
Okay.
He did time, though. He was a drug mule.
Oh. That's, like, they do remind me a lot of the Amish, and, like, the Amish are also having a tough time right now. Some dude up in, like, Lancaster County just got, like, raided by the state troopers for, like, milk and shit like that. But, like, the tough part about this is, like, you can – just like if this was priests, like we were talking about yesterday, if priests did this and they were pulling stained mattresses out of a fucking tunnel, all hell would break loose. There's tons of accounts of fucking child trafficking. Like, the Chabad dudes are, like, the mafia of those, like, that is a real bad group of dudes that can do whatever the fuck they want. So it's not fucking crazy to think that maybe they're fucking child trafficking.
Well, after checking all this shit out for exactly one day, I figured out that sometime in the 70s, these dudes became popular. And this is on borderline like a cult. And they were saying, like, there's a couple of things going on from there. Like, the world was think that they're the chosen people, okay? So, don't, like, they have 613 commandments, and all they want us to do is follow 7 of Noah's laws. That's all we got to do.
That sounds
and then we can make the whole world a better place so that the Moshiach comes. So, like, this is Looney Tunes.
Yeah, obviously, dude.
They came up with this shit, and then, but the world was getting so complicated that, like, some people, I think that they were, like, a little bit dumber or whatever.
Yeah.
They were like, oh, this is sweet. I'll just jump on board with this. I'll get on board with this. These guys will take care of me. This guy, he was handing out dollars to everybody he met. The Rebbe would give a dollar. He would hand out, like, 5 G's a day. They became, like, collector's items where people would, like, laminate them.
Yeah.
With his picture on it.
Is this one of the dudes they thought was a Messiah?
Yeah. Well, it's the main guy. It's, like, there's no, like, current Schneerson. That's the Schneerson guy.
Schneerson.
There's no, like, current powerful Rebbe, I don't think. I think after he died in 94, everything split apart. And all this warring shit they're talking about is a result of all that shit.
That must be a power vacuum, dude.
Yeah, the one BBC thing I watched was they were saying that it was like they didn't want to leave. They don't want to let Hitler win. that's why they keep their traditions.
Okay.
So, like, people in their minds sit there and go,
one
like,
guy, dude.
Dude, I know, for real.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, it's kind of like if they go back to their ancient traditions,
yeah,
like before the war stuff.
Digging tunnels.
Then it's like they didn't win. The Nazis didn't win.
Yeah,
Judaism is still alive.
Were these dudes getting rounded
up? So it's a combination of, like, it feels cozy to go back to the old nostalgia,
yeah,
and to be, like, sticking it to the fucking others.
Yeah, the ones you hate.
But they fucked up because they isolate the shit out of themselves after the war. They don't talk to anybody. They don't fucking know what's going on. They're not allowed, like, at this point, they're not allowed to have, like, TV, phones, none of that shit. So they're in outer space, bro.
I watched a whole thing on, like, what they can and can't use with electricity and stuff. And there's, like, loopholes that you, like, maybe not Orthodox, where, like, on Shabbos or whatever it is, they fucking have, like, clocks that you just pick up and it lights up so you're not turning on a light. It's very fucking
I've been in buildings where the elevator just keeps going up and down.
Yeah, that's a fucking crazy loophole.
Yeah, but, that's, like, the main thing, is that they stick to themselves and they wait for the next party. And they have these fucking parties where the Rebbe comes, and they start singing and dancing.
Is that where they're, like, fucking rocking back and forth and, like, wrecking bleachers?
It's fucking nuts, dude.
What was the tie-in with the Chabad and the Maxwells and shit like that?
They are all these... They market themselves as celebrities and powerful people, and, like, this is going back to, like, the ancient fucking Russian days where they knew they were fucked. They didn't want to get pogromed, so they would befriend the czars. So wherever they're paranoid, they're isolated.
Yeah.
And then wherever they go, they're afraid of, like, the local people, right? So instead of, like, just going, hey, guys, we're a little weird, but we're cool.
We're quirky.
They just go to the power... And they buy them.
That's fucking insane.
Then they blame guys like me and you for thinking
we're assholes.
They're puppet masters of dudes like that guy in Argentina.
These are like the dudes in The Sopranos. Remember The Sopranos when he was fucking arguing with that rabbi or whatever the fuck that was?
That was a great line.
What'd he say?
Where he's like, you fuck with us. It's like, look at what we did to the Romans. And Tony's like, we are the Romans.
Yeah. Sopranos is a good show.
Yeah, but that dude...
Like, Schneerson was, like, Maxwell's boy, wasn't he? It was, like, the last... Maxwell... Schneerson was the last dude Maxwell talked to, I thought.
No, one of the last guys... Well, before he died, one of the last things he did was chill with one of the Rebbes.
From the Chabad.
Yeah, Chabad is, like, a sect.
Yeah.
So it's, like, a kind of a sub-religion.
It's like Christ Church.
They think that if they follow these rules, they're going to bring about the Moshiach. The other Jews are like, dude, what are you talking about?
Yeah, you guys are freaking what I mean? The fuck out.
But meanwhile, they've collected an insane amount of power since they've been founded.
Yeah.
They have this book, The Tanya. They chill with that.
Do you have any of the rules?
I don't know. No. I mean, there's 613 of them.
That's a fuck ton of rules to follow.
It's like shit like don't drink pig's milk.
That's crazy. But, I didn't even know pigs had milk.
Yeah, they got milk. Okay. But, this dude, I think his name's like Elstein or something. Madam Web wrote a fucking article about it. It's very long. It's all about how this dude fucking got money from Soros, bought up all this shit in Argentina, fast forward in the future, goes to Israel, starts buying shit up there, election machines, comes back to Argentina.
And it's a wild purchase. If you had money, you're like, dude, I'm going to fucking stock up on election machines and someone's going to use this.
And they made the guy in Argentina convert to Chabad.
The dude with the hair.
Yeah. So he puts the hat on, he lights the menorah. Zelensky puts the hat on, lights the menorah.
Yeah.
So all the Chabad guys, they wonder why guys like me are going, what's up with the tunnels?
Why don't I
know that this might have to go to... I don't know, Kingston Pizza, fucking...
The Child Museum. Here's the thing, dude. The visuals are atrocious. Might be some of the worst thing that has happened to Jews visually since the Holocaust. Very fucking bad. If you're like, guys, saying that we're underground reptilian super race is anti-Semitic, and then you crawl out of a grate. It's literally the worst optics if you're trying to fight that at all. But, dude, like, the stained mattresses and shit... If we're looking at that right now, stained mattress, that's not shit. That's not where your ass is ever on a mattress, dude.
Well, I watched them take it apart. So, like, I watched a documentary.
The sledgehammer they took it to?
I watched a documentary from the 90s, and all that paneling was exactly the same. And they pulled it down.
From inside there?
Yeah. And damn. They pulled it. They ripped it down, and all the mattresses were stacked up on top of each other for, like, soundproofing.
Holy shit.
So they weren't, like, in – those mattresses weren't in the tunnel.
I saw when they smashed out, it was in behind the wall, which is like, bro, get some insulation, you motherfucker.
They don't know how shit works, bro. It's not their fault.
Please get some insulation.
They don't do shit.
Well, yeah, like,
the one guy just grabbed the side of the cement thing and started going like this. I mean, what are you going to do?
This is the thing that just tips me off, though, is at first they said it was dug by the boys. And then it was like it was actually dug during COVID because we hate the lockdown just like you guys, which is just a fucking lie. Like it was dug 6 months ago, allegedly. And then when I'm looking at that basement, if that's a 50-foot tunnel, that's like 3x4, whatever they're saying it is, it's roughly 40 yards of dirt. There's not 40 yards of dirt down the basement.
No.
Not even fucking close. And then they got the article now coming out where they're saying they hired migrants to dig it. They actually said that they first started to dig it by themselves and were getting rid of the dirt in their pockets. They said they're loading their pockets, throwing it out Shawshank Redemption style.
Yeah, they saw Shawshank, yeah.
It's fucking insane. Like, there's something fucking weird with this because there's no good excuse to have a tunnel. Like, the only shit I've ever heard was when the DuPonts were like, we don't like being in the rain, so that's why we made tunnels in Longwood Garden.
Yeah, tunnels are just for secret shit.
You're literally up to no fucking good.
I'd like to see the rest of the tunnel, though, because 50 feet's not that far.
And, dude, it's definitely not fucking just 50 feet.
I'm just saying, show me the rest of it. I also don't understand how these guys couldn't keep this under wraps. Like I said, very powerful, bro. Like, the dudes that are wrapped up in Chabad.
Yeah.
Bill Clinton flew over to Russia and brought back vintage, like, old, like, Torah-type shit.
Yeah.
Brought it back and personally gave it to Schmearson.
Fuck. These dudes are fucking powerful. It's the weird thing is, if they hand dug these things, how the fuck is there concrete on the ground and like that shit's not caving? Because you gotta like know something to be able to bury like that. You can't just dig a fucking square and be all right. Like the way they dug that tunnel, it's 100% not them.
Too many Modellas.
I didn't see the Modellas.
There's a
Modelo
bottle, yeah.
Is it really?
Yeah,
they
yeah.
could have fucking propped that, dude. I'm not believing that. But
they might be allowed to drink, too. I'm not sure.
No way, dude. They can't. That's,
I don't know.
That's what the mikvahs are for.
They're allowed to have, like, spicy little fucking bad. Like, the one guy, he's got a
you
thing
go to
with
the
sweets.
Mikvah.
He's got a problem with sweets.
What do you mean? Like, yeah, that's. Like,
there was one of the things I watched in the documentary.
Yeah,
they
I'm
struggle with sweets. I mean, they're not saints.
True.
All they gotta do is start talking to people, and they'll get humanized a little bit more. And then if they also, at the same time, said, hey, something's up with our... They can't speak out against their own community.
Yeah.
So I feel like you got a bunch of, like, really just... They're not... I'm not gonna say that they're dumb, but they're, like, isolated. So
it's like Amish. It's no different than Amish.
They don't really know what's going on. The one thing I saw with the city of Joel is they go up to Monroe County outside of fucking New York City. They start taking over the local politics.
Yes.
They're getting written up in Times of Israel for fucking smuggling drugs by a dude named Horowitz. So it's not like, this is like J on J stuff, bro.
Yeah.
This is not us. And fucking the local people are like, this is insane that this is going on. They wanted to like, the whole point of the show is they live in 1 square mile. They multiplied so much that they ended up being a voting block.
They do it everywhere.
Then they started, yeah, and instead of like talking to the regular people, regular dudes like try to come up to them and say like, hey man, can we talk? Like, I can respect your way of life. Can you understand that we moved here from the city to enjoy like, you know, the nature and stuff?
Yeah, yeah.
And they immediately just started saying that that's anti-Semitic and that there was a Holocaust. And like, dude, like people tune the fuck out.
Yeah.
Because they're sitting there going, you're tearing down trees. They wanted to have a 507-acre annexation for themselves.
That's fucking huge, dude.
And instead, and they're not building like regular houses. Like they moved up to a town where people would have like an acre.
Yeah.
They just started building apartment buildings.
That's
right?
Crazy.
Like that's what they moved from Brooklyn. So they
it's
don't.
Wild that they make it your problem too. It's like they go out there.
Oh,
they
yeah.
Get they try to get 507 acres. They like, were, dude, we have nowhere to go. It's like stop having 20.
They're collecting
kids.
More social services than two cities and two townships combined. So like they, it's not like they're free. They're, like it's not like they're making a ton of money either. There's a great clip from Defamation, if you let me play it. I'm just
go ahead.
Like, and then we can get into some of the other stuff. But fucking,
these, I mean, dude, the, you're just taking a monster L if you're a Jewish dude and the and you can't explain these tunnels. You say that, oh, I have no idea how this happened. They were doing this. We just figured out about it. It's like, dude, it's so loud. People were like hearing them under their house and shit. So it definitely goes fucking somewhere. Personally, the children's museum across the street doesn't make sense if you're trafficking kids to funnel kids into a children's museum. Won't raise that many eyebrows. And then just fucking put them over in a tunnel somewhere. That makes sense to me. Like it, I could see that fucking happening, especially since there's been accounts of these dudes doing fucked up shit like human trafficking and drug dealing.
Well, yeah. It's just, it's crazy to imagine though, if it's you and you moved out of the city and you wanted some, like a little bit of land.
Yeah.
And then this shit starts. And within like
you're sweating trying to explain how it's I don't hate you, dude. Yeah, I just don't know why you're here.
And then they have like town hall meetings where they all show up.
Yeah.
It's they're dude, when they're in groups, they're terrifying.
We just got to harness their powers for good. We got to fucking like go in with them. Like, dude,
I don't know if that's really like
you guys just got things fucking crooked right now.
Yeah, they got in with the guy that started Birthright, the Bronfmans. Fucking
they're in with the Bronfmans.
Oh, dude, it's literally like a laundry list.
Jesus.
Every like rich Jew that's connected to Epstein, they were all about it. Like the JP Morgan, like the Jess Daly dude. I don't know if you remember this stuff.
Who's Jess Daly dude?
Back from the JP Morgan. Remember when the JP Morgan shit came out?
With I gotta the dude get dying?
Feet. No, it was like all that
Oh yeah, the Epstein client list and like they kept on banking Epstein and shit like that.
It might be worthwhile checking that shit out. Here, pause it real quick.
Yeah. Yeah, I semi-remember the stuff about JP Morgan. I didn't know that that dude owned WhatsApp. That's Chabad. That's fucking insane. But who is that Ron Perlman guy?
Ron Perlman, the Perlman Center.
In Philly, or is
yeah,
it like...
Yeah, he owns okay. Revlon. He used to take... There's two, like, billionaires... Some of the bigger Chabad Lubavitch guys is Schultz. This is from a pro book, the Rebbe's Army. This is from like a very pro Chabad book.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's not like a hate thing.
Yeah.
Sheldon Adelson. I don't know if you remember Sheldon Adelson.
I remember that name.
He greeted Jonathan Pollard when he got sent out of jail. I've been reading this, dude. I'm sorry, man. This is too much because I've been reading this book called Gideon Spies.
Yeah.
And it's just like it's an approved history of Mossad by the Mossad guys. And they have these dudes that are called Sayanim, I think. I can't remember.
I won't hold you to it.
I don't speak Hebrew, so it's very tough for me. But they basically have Mossad agents, and they walk around. Guys that are foot soldiers are called Katzes.
Yeah.
But they need help. They can't just, like, you can't just drop them in Brooklyn and say, like, yo, go, you're a Mossad agent.
Yeah.
They need safe houses. They need assistance. This is where I think Chabad Lubavitch comes in, because... They are called Sayanim, and they get paid for their expenses. So if they go out of pocket, Mossad will get back to them, but they're not paid. They're doing it for the love of Israel.
Okay.
And Rafi Eitan, the dude that he's the dude. He was a badass. He's the guy that got them nukes. He used to be head of Mossad. He was way into this kind of stuff. So I have a feeling that these guys, all this shit. I'm wondering why this is in the news.
That's
these guys
what
are
I'm
very
saying.
Powerful.
Yeah.
Now, say some shit was going to go down. We're gonna about to have a whole bunch of elections.
Yeah.
There's a guy who's a Chabad fucking. According to Madam Web, they call him Mr. Landowner down in South America. All right. He owns so much shit. He owns election machines. If there's going to be like elections everywhere or whatever. If you wanted to say, dude, can we do something that will make it so that if you Google Chabad, you're only going to get this for
tunnels,
like a year.
Dude,
you know what I mean?
A.
So like Hamas tunnels, Hamas tunnels and the, you know,
Chabad,
it's like you're killing all these birds with one stone. Like we're talking about like, I'm not going to put them up.
Because they don't take L's like this.
I'm not going to put them up there with the Catholics, but they're powerful. Like,
oh, yeah.
They're not like the Vatican.
Yeah.
They're fucking up there, dude.
I mean, they got pics with all the presidents, bro.
Oh yeah.
And that, but that is like the only thing I can think of is I'm not gonna give it a Pizzagate like stamp where it's like, dude, these people are trafficking kids, but they're definitely doing some fucking weird shit. Whether it's like moving those Mossad agents around or like,
well, I think the regular citizenry of the Chabads don't know that this shit's going on.
Fuck no, dude.
And then the higher ups are sitting there money laundering, getting BB to roll up, getting blessings from the Rebbe.
Yeah, and like they have to go to him, the Rabbi, for everything.
I mean, when Robert Maxwell was going down for, when he was going down for, he stole everyone's 401ks.
He was like a Ponzi schemer?
He got fucked up, dude.
Are you serious?
Yeah. He was like, yeah, he fucked up with everyone's pensions, I think, for the Mirror. That was like that's a newspaper.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But, yeah, he probably went to go see his Rebbe.
Dude,
I saw, like, I can't remember what it's called, but I saw, like, the Lady Ghislaine yacht, pretty big.
It's fucking huge, yeah. Bro. It's crazy that dude had that helicopter, too. That, with the green line on that helicopter, that shit's fucking weird as hell.
What are you talking about?
On Maxwell's helicopter in that Netflix show.
Oh, I didn't see it.
Oh, he has a green lion and like an alchemy.
Oh, yeah. I did see that. I know what you're talking about.
Dude,
yeah.
It's fucking bizarre. But, dude.
That guy, Ron Perlman, I was talking about, because I'm pissed off about the fucking Marvel thing. So they're supposed to have
What's he have to do with Marvel?
I have to look it back up, dude.
Or who was it's not him who owns Marvel, right? It's some other dude.
I can't remember. It's something, he's something to do with Chabad, though.
Yeah.
He's a big Chabad guy.
Yeah, he, like, fucking owns everything, which is hilarious.
But, I'd have to find it again.
When did they come out with, what's their Israeli superhero?
Sabra.
When did they come out with that shit?
What do you mean?
Like, when did
it's
she...
It's not out yet.
Oh, so they never came out with, like,
that's probably not a good time, dude.
Yeah, it's a real bad time.
They were getting a lot of backlash teasing it out like a year ago.
Yeah. I mean, I think you might be right on with your them muddying up all the stuff for voting and everything.
I mean,
that's
all I can. If I had to put my conspiratorial hat on.
Yeah.
Or they didn't realize this was going to bring the news or the cops.
Bro, they had to have.
They're claiming that they called the cement truck to fix bricks.
That's just not how construction works, but like. That's what I'm saying. Like the only thing I think there's some weird stuff, or it's just for more fucking headlines because everyone's running with it. They're just saying random shit, and it's like a million Twitter threads every time they come out and say what actually happened. They were saying it was two warring fucking factions of the Chabad trying to get this building, too. Shit made zero sense.
Yeah, I mean, it was an interesting little dip into Hasidic culture. I mean, they are hilarious.
Dude, I mean, that's...
The Yiddish alone is hilarious. The dancing kills me. The City of Joel movie started out, I thought it was like, this is going to be great. They actually ended up separating from the township and starting their own city. And it's the first time that there's been a new city in New York in forever. It's called Palm Tree.
Really?
So it used to be called Place of Joel, and now it's called Palm Tree. And they ended up getting like another 160 acres to go build on.
That's fucking wild that they even know how to do that.
What do you mean?
Like, how the fuck would you go about making your own city?
Oh, yeah, they just, you know, file for it.
That's fucking insane.
They wanted to, like, emancipate themselves because everyone around them was like, dude, you can't keep taking our fucking tax money.
Yeah, true. Yeah, that's what everyone tried to tie this shit to the fucking Epstein list, and there's not there, dude.
What are you talking about?
Like, people are trying to say, oh, this is about Epstein, like the tunnels and shit like that because the Epstein list came out or whatever. That thing is, like, people were like, you have to look into this. It's just a fucking court case. Where you can't believe anything in there because you could put anyone in a fucking court case. Like there's no, it's not like the list or the black book that's been out forever. Shit's confusing as hell. Like everyone's freaking out. Like Stephen Hawking is a pervert. We've been saying that. We've known.
Well, that's in the movie, I think.
In what movie?
I think he's in the movie that you wouldn't watch because it's Eddie Redmayne. But
dude, I don't hate Eddie Redmayne. He's not that bad.
The movie where what do you call it? Yeah, he's, like, super horny. I think he cheats on his wife from a wheelchair, which is kind of a fucking flex.
Yeah, and they're saying, like, he was, like, Stephen Hawking was, like, making midgets do fucking problems on a chalkboard. Like, that was some shit he got off to.
Well, that's in the,
That's in that's whatever in the court thing is. It's fucking very fucking dumb.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Bill. I can't remember why I got on Ron Perlman, but he's a big Chabad guy.
Yeah, you were telling me last night.
He used to fly yeshiva students to his island for the weekends, but he would fly them so that they would land for the Sabbath.
Oh, so it's still within the rules.
Yeah, so they're not breaking the rules.
Yeah, dude, you know what else is fucking weird? Speaking of Epstein, when Epstein was about to get fucking caught, he ordered a cement truck to go there, and it was like a ton of yards that filled up all these fucking tunnel holes before that dude went to fucking jail.
Sorry, dude. I figured it out. I'm sorry. You just... If you bring something up, it'll fucking eat away in my head. Like, why did I connect?
Yeah, because you were on his ass last
time. I was on his ass because him and Carl Icahn invested in Marvel,
dude. There it is. Okay.
And that's where you get the Sabra. Sabra was just like a thrown in there, sort of like a Superman, sort of like a mutant.
Yeah.
It's like she's like a rogue X-Man that she gets roped into.
It's crazy they made Captain America New World Order and they were going to put Sabra in that.
I know. It was an L. And then they switched it. To Brave New World, which is, to me, no better.
Yeah.
So they went from dystopia to like utopia.
Yeah.
Whatever. But fucking. So Sabra. She's a regular IDF police. I think she's a police. I'm not sure.
She's a Mossad agent.
No, she gets...
Oh, you're talking origin story.
Once she exhibits her mutant powers, they put her into the weapons program that Captain America gets put into.
Okay.
That Weapon X is in.
You.
Weapon X. So, allegedly, that's the deal, is like the Mossad was running their own Weapon X, trying to make their own Wolverine.
Yeah.
And they took the mutant powers. It was just Sabra.
Yeah,
and she's one of the weapons. Like Captain America is supposed to be the first weapon.
Yeah. Gay. I don't fuck with Captain America.
I don't fuck with him either, bro.
Not my fucking cup of tea.
But Carl Icahn, Ron Perlman, and this other dude, Perlmutter, they are the Marvel. They're putting money into Marvel. And it just has
a ton of money.
Yeah, and there's a lot of fucking military money that goes into it. And if you look at shit like I never got into Iron Man, mm-hmm. but like Elon's in Iron Man.
Musk is?
Elon's in it, yeah. And they like wanted to make it like... So it's like a chicken and egg thing. Like, they wanted to make Iron Man like Musk.
Yeah, dude.
So
you can't be fueling him, making him go into fucking Iron Man mode.
They made him put him in demon mode.
That is fucking insane. I had no idea that Elon Musk was in Iron Man.
He's in Iron Man too, I think.
That's nuts.
But the U.S. military donated a lot of stuff to make the Hulk movies and the Iron Man movies. Because they're real military. And maybe the Superman. Superman's DC, but... That one had a lot of military shit in it, too. Who knows?
Yeah, it is. Especially once you, like, get into, like, them being Mossad and, like, all them doing their movies and shit like that. It's just weird that they're involved in Marvel.
I wasn't a fan of the white Captain America.
Yeah.
Probably not going to be a fan of the black Captain America.
No.
Probably not going to get into Sabra. Just not my cup of tea, bro.
Not for me.
I like supernatural beings. Gods.
I agree with you.
I like Asgard. That's just more my speed.
I'm more of a wizard man myself.
Yeah.
It isn't. I wish I had the balls that you had to fearlessly take on supplements like that.
I'll eat them all.
To become a Weapon X. I don't know what the fuck it is, but like I used to like crush pre-workout, no problem. Now like I'll go like half a scoop or like I won't do anything and I just get real weird. So like sometimes the gym just feels very weird and strange to me.
You might be trying to hold on to something and you have like gains and all this stuff and like you're a young guy with a trajectory. You probably have a story in your head like I'm going to be this.
Yeah.
I'm done. I've given up.
Yo, but you'll stay natural the whole time.
Adamantium, bro. Put it in my bones.
What the fuck is adamantium?
You think he was born with metal bones? Come on, man. He's Weapon fucking X. There was 9 before him.
Jesus Christ, dude. You will, at least promise me you'll stay natural.
I'll stay natural, but you bought me this fucking Turkesterone.
Turkesterone, supposedly it doesn't work.
Okay.
I was like looking at
I'm going to have a hard time doing the fucking whey protein. I got to get a blender for that shit.
Unflavored whey protein is a veteran move. Like, if you're throwing that down, dude, you might as well just do steroids at that point.
Might as well just drink pig milk.
Save yourself the fucking hurt, dude. Also, another thing that's been fucking pissing me off, and everyone has been freaking out about it, were the aliens at the Miami Mall. That is absolute fucking bullshit, because
What about those gray things in the video?
Dude, they're trying to say they're in Brazil now, too. They're going for grace so fucking hard. All that shit that went down, there was kids shooting fireworks at each other, right? I was sleeping one night, and at 12:30 at night, or at the park near my house, all these kids were chilling there, and they wouldn't leave. The cops did the same shit, dude. I thought someone was going to, like, release a dirty bomb or something. There was a cop, like, bumper to bumper around a square park, dude. Sirens and everything. Same fucking shit.
Yeah, it might be some Jade Helm shit. It might be like the new way they're going to
respond to
stuff.
I saw one theory that it was a Grand Theft Auto fucking commercial getting filmed, but there's no fucking way.
That would be sick.
That would be fucking awesome. Yeah, that, like, for some reason, people are fucking, they're, people crave aliens right now. And I'm afraid that people are going to will them into existence.
Yeah, they want, what did they call it, disclosure?
Disclosure, whatever the fuck that shit is. They're fucking spazzing. There's like, there was a footage of aliens or some shit up on a mountain in Brazil, and people are like, these are 10-foot fucking aliens. Every time, they're fucking 10 feet. You know the grays have been small ever since.
What was that one that I was telling you had Credo in it?
Oh, the chick one, who had sex with an alien.
Yeah, and of course he's like 6'4".
6'4".
Blonde. Like, dude, there's never a fucking a hobbit, bro.
They're meant for interdimensional travel,
They
bro.
Save Middle Earth, dude. They are the heroes.
Come on, bro. What the fuck is wrong with you? You can't fucking, no spoils, please, for the love of God. Yeah, I don't know, like, people are, like, spazzing for some reason. They want the aliens bad. If they do it, it's 100%, like, I'm so gone to where if there was some sort of disclosure and they were, like, flying around the sky, I would just be like, fake. Fake, don't believe it. That is just some sort of fucking weird mirage.
That's Blue Book, right?
That's what, yeah, that's what
There's
I think
Blue
it
Bean,
is.
Wait, I can't remember which one's which. One of them involves holograms. Where they're going to trick you so bad.
I think it's Project Blue Beam, and then Blue Book is some other thing. It's like Blue Book is some weird operation. Also, dude, really sorry to fucking inform you, they're having their Disease X walk through the 17th of January.
What's that supposed to mean?
They're doing, you know, they had their like a
Event 201?
Event 201. They're doing a Disease X.
Oh, like a Claydex?
Yeah.
Disease X.
All right. Yeah, Disease X, January 1st. The World Economic Forum is going to do a little walkthrough.
Not to bum me out.
You're going to have to put the mask back on. It's not for your safety. It's for everyone around you, dude. I have no clue
what
how they're
happens
focus.
In the gymnasio.
What do you mean?
When the, I mean, how am I going to get a pump?
We have to go back to the shower. You know where the Shire is, dude. City Fitness, that's one thing I don't like about them. They fucking went real gay with all that, all the COVID stuff. It was like proof of vaccination, mask, all that shit. Also, Fauci took a massive L as well.
What do you mean?
Stop walking and reading your little book, dude. You're not them. Stop code switching on his SIDS. They'll never let you in their club, dude. No, Fauci had like some closed door meeting. Please stop doing that.
Did you know that Ghislaine gets given food by a Chabad?
Does she really? In jail?
Called Reaching Out, that's connected to the Clinton Foundation. Go on.
Yeah, Fauci came out and they were like questioning him. There's going to be a real like one you can watch on YouTube like later this month or next month. But he was saying literally has no idea where social distancing came from. It kind of just popped up and he went with it.
Yeah, I mean, dude, record. He got busted on his fucking emails taking hydrochloroquine.
He said, I don't recall 174 times. Yeah. In the questioning, he said, I can't remember. Dude, question me about
this will
COVID.
Be Nuremberg 2.0.
No, it's not going to happen, dude, because...
Heads will roll.
No, it's... Our boy's
You
out.
Knew who was a big fucking Chabad guy? Eli Weasel.
Really?
Oh, yeah, big time.
What's Gave that book you wrote?
Night,
yeah.
Used to be fiction. Now yeah. It's nonfiction.
That
crazy
is
move.
Brutal.
Crazy move by Obama.
Yeah, that was probably for the Muslim Brotherhood. The other shit that freaked me out, I feel bad for you because you have a newer whip. Fucking cars are 100% stealing all of your data. Anything you do in your vehicle.
Yeah, dude.
No, yeah. I'm saying like talking.
Bro, in the Gideon book. They had a thing back in the day. We've talked about it for sure. Probably when I was talking about Pine Gap, they had this thing called Echelon. They were just listen. They can listen from the satellites.
What?
Anywhere, anybody, anywhere.
Damn, dude.
Yeah, that's... anybody, like literally anything they want to do, they can listen to you, dude.
Yeah, that's the thing that's freaking me out because they're saying Volkswagens are going to get ChatGPT in them. If you're your whip stopping you if you're getting close
Elon's,
to stuff.
Elon's trying to make a AI learning car. Because they tried to do it off of visuals,
yeah.
But he's getting pitched where what he's really creating is an AI company. So, like, Tesla has self-driving. He's also making a thing called Optimus. That was Optimus. Optimus was the first one.
Got to give it to him. I would have the same. I feel like I had a better juice, but he's good names for shit.
Well, before you say that, you might want to check out some of his kids because he's giving some blacks the run for their money, dude. First of all, his kids.
Motherfucker's name X.
First of all, some of the funniest shit. If you want to get into Elon Musk, dude, some of the funniest shit is his dad's Twitter. Dude. Calling his kid, saying his kid's got a limp dick, probably because all of Elon's kids are made in a fucking homunculus. I think he's trying to do the Newtonian alchemical homunculus, where he's building, him and Grimes are building triplets in a cup.
But him and Grimes are done.
Then he names them, one of them, fucking dude.
X-A-E, fucking whatever. He couldn't put, that is kind of fucked up that you can't put numbers in it.
The one's short, his nickname is Tao, but his real name is hilarious, bro.
Yeah, I mean,
I just gotta look it up.
Musk and Grimes, whatever that was like conceiving, did they do all test tubes?
I think he's done like some, he's done IVs, IVF,
yeah,
and surrogates.
Surrogates is fucking
so
wild.
He's they're paying people for
Grimes is like legitimately scary. Like,
she's the
human.
One that comes up with like demon mode and war mode and all this shit for him.
Maybe she's not that bad. The only thing I know of Grimes is when Lex Fridman dropped to the knee to her and had her on. It was simping hard as shit on his gas with her.
I'm not. I got to look this up, man. The one kid. So X is XA12.
Yeah. Can't have fucking numbers. So he did Roman numerals.
The other one's great, though.
Can't you just look up all of his kids' names?
Dude, there's so many of them. And they all have whacked out names.
How many kids is he fucking
He had? Also started just like, there was a chick that he was working with who he was gaming with. He has time to game a lot, so like he's...
That's one thing I just don't understand. Because like if you are running Tesla, the only thing I could think of how he could game is if he literally just hits himself with, I'm working 9 o'clock to 5 o'clock and then the phones are off.
His mom yelled at him for gaming. He missed a meeting because he was gaming. He was playing this game called Polytopia.
Yeah, dude, that shit's too fucking weird. You can't be a grown man gaming that.
I have a hard time. I mean, I got more of a problem with Kimball, honestly. But
why?
It's a pussy, dude. Okay, yeah, here is his name. Tao Musk, dude. His real name is Techno Mechanicus.
Yeah, he's just doing whatever the fuck he wants.
Yeah,
he
but anyway, he's got
a simulation.
Anyway, he's got Optimus Prime, which is like a human shaped android, which is what he's really pushing for. It's like Data from TNG. I grew up on TNG. I'm not, you know.
TNG?
Yeah, Next Generation. Star Trek, bro.
Oh, okay. I thought you were saying
all
TNT.
Of his shit is from movies.
Obviously.
He wants to go to Mars because he talked to James Cameron one time at a dinner.
Yep.
He wants Neuralink to create Geordi from fucking Next Generation. Geordi
Star
is
Trek.
LeVar Burton. He wears a fucking visor. And he
is that
can,
the eye visor?
Yeah.
That's so sick.
And he can see more of the world than we can.
Okay.
So he can see like... A bigger spectrum of
broader
shit.
Spectrum, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. That's like part of Neuralink.
Yeah.
Then he wants to create Data. Data's another character on Next Generation who is an android who's always searching for his dad. His dad created him.
He's not making up anything. Like, everything that this dude has came out with is fucking just already made up or bought from. But, dude.
And he has these spazzes where he, like, shit's not going good or he's bored. So then he has, like, surges. And he tells everybody, like, he's hitting the factory floor, but, like, he's sleeping in the office, and, like, everyone's looking
at
him.
He's a work liar, bro.
Dude, everyone's looking at him like, there's no need for this. He's sleeping. And they're just, like, laughing at him, kind of. They're just like, all right, dude, he gets Twitter, right? Remember?
X, bro.
Sorry.
You're good.
Remember Raw? Remember, what's the guy's name? Eli Roth or what? Remember the guy that was in charge of censorship and, like, he was kind of like a
for
pedo.
Twitter.
He was kind of like a pedo.
Yeah, yeah.
Remember this guy?
Yes.
He got blasted on. They accused him of that anyway.
Of pedophilia on X.
Yeah, you remember this guy? Like you were going off on this dude. And yeah.
There's so many enemies, bro.
Too many. But one of Musk's main thing was like he got in there and he was like all about no doxing. No looking, no like any of this shit.
Yeah.
He was like, yo, show me what everyone's been saying about me. And went through all
obviously,
their shit, dude.
Obviously,
oh, yeah.
Obviously, that's
then
what
hit
you
demon
do.
Mode.
I mean, like, it's fucking crazy that he did all that shit, and now it's like, oh, an Israeli company's going to identify you thoroughly if you want to have a blue check mark on X.
Yeah.
It's fucking, I mean, this dude is
all this, all that, the election company that dude, Elstein bought in South America.
Elstein.
It's called, like, it was called something more Hebrew, but it's called Magic Election. Magic.
Horrible name for election shit.
Yeah, I'd have to look it back up.
Yeah, these dudes are just fucking up to no good. When I was on a fucking mad one last night, just like trying to figure out how the fuck they make tunnels, dude. And like, it is getting rid of the dirt is a fucking a huge problem. But the boring machines do 35 tons an hour. Like, some boring machines is 35 tons an hour. Which on History Channel they were spazzing saying that like that would be like so many trucks, but in reality it's like a truck and a half an hour. And then they have things. This is where they could have the underground tunnels, bro. They have a thing that is, what do you call it? Patented by HAARP, and it is a nuclear drill that goes through rock and earth's crust, but it heats up the drill to 2,000 degrees, making it zero waste. And the whole cylinder that it's making is glass.
That's sick.
So that is a way that, and this was old. This is like an old-ass patent. That is a way that they could make deep underground military bases, and you never see a thing, and you kind of don't need concrete if the shit's turning to glass.
Yeah, I mean, if I get in a real crazy rabbit hole, I'm into that. I get into that stuff.
What?
Like secret government.
Oh, yeah.
The classified, or you need, you know, above top secret, yeah. It just keeps going and going and going. Yeah, and, you know, then there's another president.
Yeah, the Black Pope and shit like that.
Dude, underground, all that.
The thing that terrified me, though, and you were hitting me with it last night, is the fucking tunnels at Vietnam, dude. Fuck that
shit.
Oh,
did you watch any of that stuff?
Fuck that shit. Hell fuck that shit.
Yeah.
There was a dude who worked for my dad.
Sucks for short, guys.
Oh, my God, bro. When you were telling me, like, I thought about it, and I was like, dude, that fucking blows. And, like, they had
when they're drawing straws, dude, like, they're looking around. Like, they're not picking you to go in there.
Obviously, dude. That's why genetically I know I have to get my bench up just in case shit goes down. I don't want to get shoved in a fucking rat hole. They were doing shit. Like, the thing that fucking really freaked me out and, like, it got me, like, scared driving home is when you were saying they get you in such a maze down in those rat holes that you forget which way's up and you can just fall down shit. Like, that's fucking terrifying.
I get scared of shit. Like, you ever see, you know when you watch a video and it's a guy, like,
crawling through a cave?
Jumping off of a building.
Yeah.
And they're like, oh, or, like, a guy forgets to parachute, like that, and you get that feeling.
Yeah.
I get a feeling of tunnels.
Oh, yeah, dude.
You know, and it's, like, claustrophobic or whatever, buried alive, that kind of shit.
It's fucking terrifying.
Shit scares me. And then I started thinking, I will be buried. So that also blows.
Dude, chill the fuck out, yeah.
The Rebbe went to the Ohel where he is today. He went there.
Put me on top of a mountain, bro.
He went there before he died.
He went to where?
He went to go see where he was going to be before he died.
That's fucking tough, dude.
That's tough. That's a fucking man.
I want to get picked apart on top of a mountain by birds and shit, dude.
Oh, yeah. Sky Barrel?
Yeah, I don't need to be fucking put down there. It was just fucking wild. Like, there's like Vietnamese kids that grew up in tunnels while getting bombed the whole fucking time.
Yeah, man.
And it took them like a long ass time to dig all those tunnels.
Yeah, and those guys that were fucking around over there, that is the fucking guys from the Good Shepherd.
Yeah.
That's who did that. It's the guys from Iran-Contra. It's Shackley. It's Ted Shackley. All those bros over there in Laos. They were doing the French Connection. They were doing the drugs. They were running drugs from fucking all the way over Indochina.
That was so much money.
Through France to New York.
And that's what I'm saying. Like, do you know why the Vietnamese spaz? Was it because of drugs and shit?
What do you mean?
Like, why did North Vietnamese or whatever, whoever, the Viet Cong freak out? We're like, dude, fuck this shit. And started going to war.
I don't know. Like, I don't really know who created the war.
Yeah, it is fucking bizarre. Because these dudes.
I think you, like, bring it to a war. Like, yeah, like,
well, they were fucking warring with France.
Well, they were always there. Like, the CIA, like, inherited it.
Yeah, dude. Like, because they had fucking a ton of tunnels. Like, but way before Vietnam. And then they just went ham. Dude, they're going, like, 35 feet a day.
Yeah, I mean, America was there. If that one book, the Fletcher Prouty book, they say America was there right after World War II. We were there in the 40s, bro. And then when Kennedy got in, he was like, yo, I think it was like 1600 or something, special operation guys. Like, just not even, they were like consultants.
Yeah.
Not even like doing anything.
They're the dudes who died, right?
No, that's the Ted Shackley. That's the ring that became Iran-Contra.
Jesus
Christ. And they're all connected to the mob.
Yeah, and supposedly Chabad is too.
Yeah.
This was...
Chabad's like a money laundering scheme, I think. Yeah. And I think it's also safe houses.
I mean, I'm pretty much with you.
I'm just, hey, dude, I got to, you know, you're asking me. You asked me to find out fucking shit about the Chabad people.
Yes.
And that you were going to figure out tunnels.
Yes.
And this dude, Donald Lauder, who's like boys with Trump. All these dudes are boys with Trump, by the way.
Obviously, dude.
Right? So that's kind of an L.
It's over for the Trump. Like, all this shit that's coming out, dude, Disease X, all this shit, you're going to have Trump again. Like, dude, he's not going to save you. No one's going to save you. It's fucked.
Yeah, I think he just hit, like, a good time.
He came at a perfect time,
he
dude.
He hit a good time.
It's like that movie, Co, where it's like, dude, we spent time together. It was beautiful, and now it's over.
One of the big...
You're not going to recreate it. It's like going back out with an ex.
One of the big Chabudniks is this dude, Donald Lauder, who's also a Likudnik. And he fucking, he makes up, he sits there and he meets the Rebbe and he gets so touched by him. Everybody that meets the Rebbe is like, this changed my life. Obviously. The one guy, Elstein, like he had all this money in he had all this money in the stock market. He met the Rebbe and the Rebbe said, go to real estate, bro. And then he went to real estate.
Yeah.
You know? And like this guy, Elstein, who's like the puppet master of South America right now, this guy he got $10 million from Soros on a weird thing when he was 30.
On a weird thing, bro. What do you mean?
Dude, he claims that like Soros just saw something in him.
Yeah.
And he gave him $10 million. And it was a happenstance
meetup.
Invest
in me, make your dollars.
It was a happenstance meetup. And in reality.
That got $10 million.
But in reality, if you'd scratch, if you do a little scratch off.
Yeah. Become a scratch, Nick.
It was a Chabad hookup.
Jesus.
So like,
Christ.
This is what they're doing. They're, this is what I'm saying. If they were out in the open about it, it'd be one thing.
Yeah.
But it's all, and then they have tunnels, and you're going, bro.
Yeah.
What's up with the tunnels?
Pro tip, stop burden maxing your community. You can't redline everything your community has to offer, then be like, dude, why the fuck's everyone pissed at us?
Well, in the British stuff, it's hilarious because they live in this place. It's called Stamford Hill. And they just look at the cops as like another service that is owed to them.
I mean, kind of, you know? Yes. And the videos I've been seeing lately, I mean, I don't have their sex. Like, they're fucking pissing me off with the way they act. Sometimes they act like we work for them.
But the dude, the one dude, Donald Lauder, he gets so touched by the Rebbe that he wants to start a bunch of summer camps.
Where?
In Europe.
Okay.
And just so that the kids could have a good time. And he pays for it all.
Yes.
It's probably innocent.
I would hope so.
Just like the art camp that Epstein had. Probably completely different. Completely innocent.
Let Worm live, man. Let him live.
Kevin Hart's flipping out about that.
Why?
It's all the shit. The fucking...
Dude, the thing is, like, he didn't say... The thing, you peeled me on Cat Williams, because the whole time I'm sitting there watching this dude, I'm like, oh, wow, he was in the first Friday. That, all that shit's about the second Friday.
Is it a sequel, the Christmas movie Friday that, like, I mean, I don't know, maybe in the black. We live in two different worlds.
Obviously.
Man. Black people live
in
another
world. We're
white
Knicks, bro. Yeah. We're big time white Knicks.
It is what it is, dude. I don't know. Maybe fucking next Friday is this big deal, or Friday after next. I don't even know which one. He might be in Friday After Next, which I think is not even the sequel, but the third.
Yeah, that would be the third.
I got to look it up.
The sequel would be Next Friday. Keep up.
I think I saw Next Friday.
Keep up,
and I think
boy.
Friday After Next, one of them, I remember one of them, they end up in the suburbs, and I was kind of like, I'm kind of done with this.
Yeah, unrealistic.
And it sucks, because like, dude, if you bring up Friday to me, everyone remembers Chris Tucker and Debo.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's different in the black community. Money Mike might be a big deal. Yeah. On Club Shay Shay.
I mean,
big deal.
I guess it is crazy that, like, if you go in, and you were in there for a while, the Bernie Mac, like, fucking black, gay, Illuminati.
What?
Remember when you were, like, in the Bernie Mac hole? Pause. Remember you did that shit where you're looking into, like,
let him live, bro.
The blacks and how they all do gay shit?
No, there's a conspiracy where they killed Bernie Mac.
Yeah.
There used to be a video, I think it was, like, it's either, like, 48 or 52 minutes.
Oof, that's
if you
nice.
Can try to find it, it's a cozy fucking watch, and it's kind of like, I think the gist of it is like Steve Harvey is kind of like on the bad team, I would believe that. Bernie Mac. I can't remember.
I mean, it seems like everyone is spazzing out, and Cat Williams is kind of telling the truth. He's saying shit I would say if I knew I was right, saying he's got like 100 witnesses and shit like that.
Yeah, but I mean, he's lying. He's lying on his numbers.
Dude, 3,000 bucks is steep.
Yeah.
Unless it was C spot run 1,000 fucking times, bro. I'm surprised you let the you were obsessed with that dude who jumped the judge for like a day, then you just let him live.
I mean, I just think that was a funny gif.
That was the most that and the fucking Jew tunnels were insane. That dude 5-star frog splashed that fucking judge. That was like a legit high jump. Those fucking things have to be at least like 5'8".
Yeah, he's just schizophrenic, allegedly.
Is he really?
Yeah, I watched the whole thing where they were like, dude.
Felt for him?
He can be recovered. Like, he has done well in the past. He just slipped up, and the judge was like, yeah, nah, I think we're done with that. Yeah. He's going to do some real time.
Obviously, that dude fucking spazzed big time.
Yeah, it's the third Friday.
All right, bro. Like, he has to chill the fuck out. He's also on a sus list for having all those adopted kids and no wife.
Yeah, that Elstein dude has this thing called magic. Magic, I just had it, dude. Anyway, it's called Magic. It's like his voting. It's called MSA. It's called MSA, and he bought a voting company. So he's just going to...
The voting company is actually called Magic.
Yes.
Come on, man.
It was called like Mendev or something. Something more Hebrew.
Yeah.
But...
Maybe that just means magic in Yiddish.
I guess, dude.
They
do like to do jokes. I think that they're... I think one of their attack vectors is called Gospel.
Okay.
Over in Gaza. Yeah, I think they like to do the irony.
Yeah, if I hear magic voting machines are coming out in 2024, dude, I'm heading for the fucking hills. Cuz that is going to be fucked up.
Yeah, there's a quote in the one article, there was a quote where it was like, if you wanted to coup a country, you could, I'm going to fuck this up, but it's like you could get tanks in the army and go drive down and go have a coup.
Too expensive.
Or you could just get election machines.
Yeah.
And then you know, if everybody wanted you out because of they didn't like what you were doing.
Yeah, obviously. And it's in everything I watch about South America. That's all they fucking do. Some places they did body, but they just go to the elections, overturn the elections, get their guys in.
Yeah, I don't think they have to try as hard in
It's super easy.
It's fucked up that Tucker had that dude on. Like, Tucker...
That was weird as fuck.
Tucker had the gremlin guy on.
That was crazy.
Tucker had Javier Milei on or whatever.
Who's Javier Milei?
The guy I'm talking about. This Argentina.
Okay.
He's the president of Argentina.
Yeah, that is fucking...
He converted to become what he is. And he says he loves Israel and he loves the IMF. And IMF bodies fucking countries like Argentina.
Yeah, obviously. He just took a ton of money for them.
For some reason, they want Patagonia, which I think is...
The Giants.
I think it's some secret shit like that.
Absolutely,
like, as
bro.
Soon as everyone's like, oh, what's the obsession?
Quick base to Antarctica.
Yeah, there's like a bunch of... You can juggle a lot of balls here. Like, why do they want fucking Iraq? And it's like, oh, Greater Israel. It's like, or Stargate.
True.
You know what I mean? Like, true. Or Babylon. Who the fuck knows, bro?
That is fucking weird that they want Patagonia. And, there's been all sorts... There was stuff... I think it was Peru... Where they were fighting, allegedly they were fighting aliens, but it turned out it was just like cartel dudes with jetpacks. Like, there's some fucking weird ass shit that's going down in South America.
They have fucking jetpacks, dude.
I mean, yeah, dude. They got, like, you ever see the dudes that the water packs?
Yeah, I've seen the water packs.
There's no way they don't have the jetpack.
Yeah, whatever. I mean, that's cool.
If I went deep into my memory, I could remember.
Cartels also love tunnels.
Obviously, dude. That's El Chapo was the king of tunnels. That's what he built the shit. That's the other thing. The air supply was very confusing as to what the fuck they did for that, for those fucking Chabad tunnels.
I don't think they got that far. It's just 50 feet, dude.
Maybe. It could connect. Like, dude, there's so much shit underground in fucking New York. It's insane. Like, they have all sorts of stuff. There was a dude.
The book right there, the mole people.
Book. I know.
Yeah.
I was watching this documentary. There was a dude. Who there was a huge underground thing that, like, when they would build these underground places in New York, they would dig the whole road up, like the Romans, and make a brick arch and then backfill the road and put the cobblestones down and be good to go. And this dude, this fucking greedy real estate developer was like, this fucking tunnel is a nuisance and we need to demo it and I'm going to fill it back in. And he got, like, what is in today's, like, I think $3 million. And all he did was brick up both entrances to the tunnel and that's it.
That's good.
And then supposedly Chinatown's riddled with fucking tunnels. And that's all like Yakuza and whatever, that the Triad Gang or some shit like that. That stuff's weird. Those dudes do not fuck around, dude. They love fucking hatchets.
Dude, I'm not trying to be a dick, but like I can see they're industrious. I can see that shit going down.
Yeah.
It's tough for me to believe the Rebbe's pulling these fucking maneuvers.
Yeah.
They're coming up with dirt coming out of the pockets.
That is
tough. You know what I mean? Dude. Like that's a tough one.
I think everything about this just doesn't make sense. Like, especially if you're saying
it's hard to work in that uniform.
It's impossible. The Amish do beast it though.
Different uniform.
Is it really?
Yeah, it's slightly different.
Slightly different modifications for fucking blowing out trucks. It's modded, and shit like that.
It's modded.
Honestly, power rankings, I would still put Amish over Hasids right now. They haven't done anything to beat the Amish out and fucking weird dudes that don't talk to
anyone. I think they have to take a deep breath. Maybe stop thinking that they're smarter.
Yeah.
Just for a little bit. Just be like, dude, we kind of look dumb.
Ask for help.
We kind of look dumb right now, don't we?
Yeah. That's
little egg on their face. That's all. Let's laugh about it, bro.
Let's have fun. The argument, though, where it's like we're trying to expand it, it's like, dude, what are you expanding with that?
I'm telling you, dude, this is just shit people are saying. It's just to keep it in whatever world you're in.
Yeah, dude. It really is.
In the future, you're going to be like, man, this is crazy. You're going to try to tell somebody about some connection to a world leader. Like, maybe you go back and look at his PSYOPs programs with the Russians and Trump and Putin and Zelensky and be like, oh, dude, Chabot Lubavitch has all right. And then they'll Google it and it just comes up tunnels.
Yeah, that and never went fucked. Anywhere. I wish it would at least make it a little more juicy, but I did say in 24, I'm not falling for the shit.
Yeah, it's just, hey, dude, I'm just going to
let it hit you like you do when you're fucking going out to the ocean. Just let the wave hit you and just keep on going out, bro.
Yeah, I mean, what are the odds?
The odds of what?
Like, you're sitting there like, man, I hope there's some happenings.
Oh, yeah. I mean, this is just fucking insane. It is. It's weird as shit, though. Like, the setup they had down the basement was fucking gross. Like, you can't have all that dirt down the basement with, like, height chairs and strollers and shit.
Well, that tiled shit, I think, is the mikveh.
Oh, that's, like, their bathhouse?
I think that's the boys' mikveh. And the guys can do their bath many times a month. And the girls are encouraged.
Supposedly, they're supposed to hit the mikveh if they jerk it.
Well, yeah, I mean, they were, like, going nuts. In the one documentary I watched,
they turn up.
They were getting hit. In England, they were getting hit with, like, street-walking prostitutes, and they can't handle it.
Obviously.
So it's like they don't like how this is making them feel. They pick them up in the car, and then they say, like, what are you doing? And they're like, you know what I'm doing. It's a date. And they're like, I'm going to kill you. Get out of here.
Holy
shit. Like, they don't know how to handle that.
I wouldn't either, dude. If you stopped all of my education at third grade and then just put me out of the world and say you have to not sin.
I don't know where you're getting the third grade thing from.
Vice. Anti-Semitic rag.
Yeah. I mean, I think Vice might be some disinfo on that. Some smarty pants grad student probably wrote that.
It seems
a lot of these guys are going to ninth grade, okay?
Yeah, I mean, I think I clocked out then, so I'm right there with them.
They're bilingual.
True, honestly. They got that on me.
Yeah.
I don't know shit. But hold on.
Can I get a beer?
Yeah, good. Let me get up my list.